In addition to the series connection of components, electronic circuits often involve components connected in parallel. In an earlier lesson, we saw how cells or batteries could be connected in parallel to increase the current capacity of a circuit. Resistors can also be connected in parallel. In a parallel resistive circuit, the resistors are connected across each other. Each individual parallel component, or branch, as parallel circuits are called, has its own current path. Therefore, unlike series circuits, where the same current must flow through all components, in a parallel circuit, the total current is made up of the individual branch currents. As a parallel resistor or branch is added, an additional path for current is added, and the total current goes up. We might also say that as additional parallel paths are added, the amount of conducting, or the total conductance, goes higher. Now let's see how this works with specific resistors. Here we have a single 10-ohm resistor. We could consider that the resistor is a conductive path, indicated by the letter G for conductance. For this resistor, the conductance would equal the reciprocal of the resistance, 1 divided by 10 ohms. This equals 1/10 of a siemen, 0.1 siemens, for the 10-ohm resistor. If we now were to add a second 10-ohm resistor in parallel with the first, we could say that a second conductive path of 0.1 siemens was added to the circuit. The total conductance in the circuit, G sub T, would then be equal to G1 plus G2. For this circuit, G1 is 0.1 siemens and G2 is 0.1 siemens, which equals 0.2 siemens. In electronic circuits, we see the components as resistors, not conductances, so we need to convert conductance values to resistance values. Since resistance is the reciprocal of conductance, the total resistance value in this circuit equals the reciprocal of 0.2 siemens. Taking the reciprocal of 0.2 gives 5 ohms as the total resistance of the circuit. The formula for total parallel resistance is, therefore, based on the conductance concept and is written as the reciprocal of the total resistance equals the reciprocal of the first resistance plus the reciprocal of the second resistance plus the reciprocal of each of the parallel resistors. Beginning with the formula for total parallel resistance, for this circuit we have the reciprocal of 10 ohms plus the reciprocal of 10 ohms. Using our calculator, we enter 10 and press the reciprocal key. 0.1 is displayed. Then plus is pressed. Then we key in the second 10 and press the reciprocal key. Again, 0.1 is displayed. When equals is pressed, the total conductance, 0.2 siemens, is displayed. The total resistance then equals the reciprocal of 0.2 siemens, so the reciprocal key is pressed again and the calculator displays 5 ohms, the total resistance. Notice that when we added a second resistor in parallel with the first, the total resistance went lower. The single most important rule to remember regarding resistors in parallel is that the total parallel resistance is always less than the lowest individual parallel resistance value. We can also emphasize a second point using this circuit where the individual branch resistors are of equal value. The total resistance is exactly half of one branch resistance, and this illustrates a special case involving equal parallel resistances. The total resistance equals the value of one of the branch resistances divided by the number of equal resistors, or R sub T, the total resistance equals R, the value of one of the equal resistors divided by N, the number of equal resistors. If there had been 5 parallel 10-ohm resistors, using the formula R sub T equals R divided by N, the total resistance is equal to 10 ohms divided by 5, the number of equal resistors. This, of course, would equal 2 ohms. Remember, though, that this only works for equal parallel resistors. Here we have a slightly more complicated parallel circuit with 3 parallel branch resistors. To calculate the total parallel resistance, we use the general formula. Substituting the values into the formula gives us 1 over 150 ohms plus 1 over 470 ohms plus 1 over 220 ohms. Keying these values into our calculator one at a time gives us 150 reciprocal, 0.00667 is displayed, plus 470 reciprocal, 0.00213 is displayed, plus 220 reciprocal, 0.00455 is displayed. Pressing equal shows the total conductance, which equals 0.01334 siemens. Now pressing the reciprocal key and equals one last time gives us the total parallel resistance, 75 ohms. Note that this total parallel resistance is less than the value of the lowest individual branch resistance. So the general rule for a parallel circuit is useful as a simple and quick check of your calculations. To demonstrate a very helpful final rule for resistors in parallel, let's return to our earlier two-resistor circuit. Remember that the total resistance was 5 ohms for the circuit with two 10-ohm resistors in parallel. Let's add a third resistor with a value of 100 ohms in parallel with the other two resistors. If we use the parallel resistance and substitute our values, we can calculate the total resistance. The total is 4.76 ohms, very close to the 5 ohms we calculated for the two 10-ohm resistors. This leads to a final general rule for resistors in parallel called the rule of 10 to 1. It says, when calculating parallel resistance, it is okay to ignore any branch that is at least 10 times greater than the next highest branch resistance. The value won't be affected significantly. This concludes our lesson on resistance and resistors.